All right, Shalom. First off, I would like to give all glory, honor, and infinite praises to Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, Bahashem, Recha, Kodash. Double honors to the apostles and elders of Great Millstone that teach and rule well and labor in 100% doctrine, okay, according to the Bible. Shalom to the hopeful elect pushing his truth and our righteousness and in sincerity around the four winds of the earth. Shalom to the sincere believers and a few Akwaf, a few sisters coming back being silent. I'm the Akim Ha'amayan. And this morning I didn't even watch the whole 4 minute video, but the title just was an eye catcher. And I wanted to make a lesson about it. Because the so called Negro, Latinos, and Native American Indians, which you are Israelites of the Bible, that's who you are. You're the Israelites. We are the Israelites. And you fail to realize that some of you know, and some of you just know and don't care and still act like Esau, even the so-called white man, they are equal with you and you, they love you and things in that nature. No, man. They are our enemies, okay? Esau, Edom. The Lord hates them, man. The Lord hates Esau. But this four-minute video, I'm going to let it play. The title of it is, it was 2 days ago, Kyle Rittenhouse fires back at LeBron for the trial, for his trial. And I'm going to play it.
I was a Lakers fan, too, before he said that.
Really?
Yeah.
I was really pissed off when he said that. Because I like LeBron, and then I'm like, you know what? F*** you, LeBron.
See? That's how they feel. He was like, before he said it, I was just like, I like you, LeBron. But as soon as LeBron said what he said, he was just like, F you, LeBron. Hey, man. That's how they feel about us anyway. That's how they feel about the Lord with his second coming. They know he's coming back. Yeah, man, on the higher scale. That's how they feel about Jake, man. Okay? That's how they feel about us, man. But I'm going to let it play on out and bring some edifying scriptures out. Lord, will it be an edifying lesson? And I'm going to play the video.
That's Kyle Rittenhouse this past Monday appearing on the Blaze TV, reacting to a tweet that Lakers star LeBron James tweeted out after Rittenhouse broke down while taking the stand during his recent trial. James accusing the 18-year-old, who would be found not guilty on all counts, of faking his emotional reaction. What tears? I don't see one. Knock it off, LeBron ordered. Yes, that would be the same LeBron who, a little over 2 weeks after his attack on Rittenhouse, disgraced himself in front of the world and was fined $15,000 for doing this, grabbing his crotch during a game against Indiana. The man is so full of class. Yeah, that's it. LeBron is full of class.
Well, I think CNN is realizing that their ratings are dog shit.
Yeah.
And that having these highly polarizing editorial personalities like Stelter and Don Lemon, and I don't want your ideological slant. Yeah. I don't want this left-wing propaganda network, which is what CNN's become.
Joe Rogan on his show discussing the state of affairs over at CNN beyond the firing of Chris Cuomo.
The way I look at CNN now is so differently than the way I looked at CNN 15, 20 years ago.
Yeah,
I used to look at them as like, this is how I get the news. This is unbiased, professional news. Now I look at them, I go, you fucking propagandists.
Now, I will fully agree with Rogan on the second part of his analysis, what CNN has become. But I don't know that they or anyone has ever presented just the news.
Okay, they're going on something else. Like I said, I didn't watch the whole video. It's just that part I wanted to get. But let me get Micah. Chapter 2 and verse 10. And it reads, arise ye and depart, for this is not your rest, because it is polluted. It shall destroy you even with the sword destruction. This place America, man. This is not your rest here. Okay, you think you a millionaire, billionaire, and you on that status with Esau Edom. He is in his power seat. Esau Edom is in his power seat. He is in power right now, okay, temporarily. He's about to go down. His rulership is about to end. And y'all fail to realize that, man. Okay? These are Esau, these Edomites, man. Esau Edom, the so-called white man, Yeah, the so-called white man, which is the devil, the Bible speaks of. Yeah, he hates you, man. He hates you. This is not your rest. That's why it's destroying you, man. Look at you now, LeBron. You getting, you know, you the topic now. You said what you said, you know, and guess what? I understand where he's coming from because little do people know, according to scripture, let me get it, Zechariah 11 and 5. It reads, whose possessors slayed them and hold themselves not guilty. See? See? That's what he's stressing about, okay? He's stressing about the fact that the guy was not guilty. And it's worse cases than that, man. Look at what Esau Edom been doing for centuries to the nation of Israel, the Gadites. Okay, the Christopher Columbus situation. Okay, history, man, real history that the school and your so-called black leaders are not going to tell you about. Okay, they're not guilty. Emmett Till situation, not guilty. Even things that they don't publicize, things that are not written in the books. Okay, they hold themselves not guilty, man. Why? Because they the devil. And what you don't supposed to do with the devil? Let me get it. Is it Sirach? Because, see, LeBron failed to realize, man, you're going to go through this, man. 10 and 14. Or is it 12 and 14? Or 14 and 12? Yeah. Sirach. Sirach chapter 12, also known as Ecclesiasticus, chapter 12, verse 10. Never trust thine enemy, for like as iron rusteth, so is his wickedness. Never trust him. Esau Edom is the enemy. Never trust him, man. For like as iron rusteth, so is his wickedness. Excuse me, Slucky. Verse 11. Though he humble himself and go crouching, yet take good heed. And beware of him, that thou shalt be unto him as if thou hast wiped a looking glass, and thou shalt know that his rust had not been altogether wiped away. Okay, yeah, man, you got them suit and tie. They're just like the guy that was on the stand, the Kyle Rittenhouse guy. Got him suit and tie, but inside of his spirit, inside of his mind, he's wicked. He want to kill even the elites, even the Illuminatis. Their agenda is to extinct this place and kill Israel. Okay? But if it wasn't for a remnant, okay, if it wasn't for a remnant, man, this place should be wiped out, man, even along with every Israelite. But if it wasn't for a remnant, man, okay, it's a hope for the lack out here that Yahweh Shemaah Shai is going to lift up that standard for. So we're not, every Israelite is not going to be done away with, man. Two-thirds will be done away with, but that one-third is going to be set on dominion with Yahweh Shemaah Shai, man. Okay. But getting back to the scriptures, it says, verse 12, set him not by thee, lest when he have overthrown thee, he stand up in thy place, neither let him sit at thy right hand, lest he seek to take thy seat. And thou at the last remember my words and be pricked wherewith. Okay. Who would pity a charmer that is bitten with a serpent or any such as coming out wild beast? So one that goes with to a sinner and is defiled with him in his sins, who will pity? For a while he will abide with thee, but if thou begin to fall, he will not tarry. Verse 16. An enemy speaketh sweetly with his lips, but in his heart he imagineth how to throw thee in a pit. He will weep with his eyes, but if he find opportunity, he will not be satisfied with blood. See? And that's Esau Edom, man. That is Esau Edom. That's him. So LeBron, let me go back to this video.
Yeah. I was really pissed off when I said that because I like LeBron, and then I'm like, you know what? F*** you, LeBron.
That's how he feel, man. That's how they feel about Israel. Forget y'all. F y'all. Okay? And the Lord felt like that about y'all. We bring out two scriptures. Malachi 1, and I'm going to get straight to the point. Verse 3, and I hated Esau and laid his mountains and his heritage waste for the dragons of the wilderness. Okay? And I hated Esau. And I hated Esau. Verse 2, it said, at the end, it said, yeah, I love Jacob, beginning at verse 3, and I hated Esau. Okay? Romans chapter 9, verse 13. And it reads, and as it is written, Jacob have I loved. Oh, man. Shalaki. Romans 9 and 13. And as it is written, Jacob have I loved, but Esau have I hated. See? He hate Esau either, man. Let me get Ezekiel chapter 35. And verse 1, moreover, the word of the Lord came unto me, saying, son of man, set thy face against Mount Seir, and prophesy against it, and say unto it, thus said the Lord, power, behold, O Mount Seir, I am against thee. I will stretch out my hand against thee. I will make thee most desolate. It's lucky. I will lay thy cities waste, and thou shalt be desolate, and thou shalt know that I am the Lord. Why, though? Because thou hast had a perpetual hatred and shed, and has shed the blood of the children of Israel by the force of the sword, and in the time of their calamity, and in the time of their iniquity had an end. Okay? See? He had a perpetual hatred by the, and has shed the blood of the children of Israel, man, by the force of the sword. So, they hate Israel, man. The so-called Negro, Latinos, and Native American Indians, man. We are hated by Esau, Edom. And the Lord hate them. Okay? Let me get a few more. I'll close it out. It's an account I'm looking for in Genesis 27, if I'm not mistaken. If I can't find it, I'll not worry about it. Oh, yeah, Genesis 27, and let me start at, let me see, I'm trying to get to the point, but it's a lot of, it's facts, man, okay, this is the truth. And you so-called Negro, Latinos, Native American Indians fail to realize that all the answers are in the Bible that you scared to read and that you also proclaim that you have understanding of. Let me get to the point, though. I'm gonna start at verse 41. And Esau hated Jacob because of the blessing wherewith his father blessed him. And Esau said in his heart, which is his mind, okay, your mind, your heart is your mind. The days of mourning for my father are at hand, and their father was who? Isaac, okay? Abraham had Isaac, Isaac had Jacob and Esau, okay? And the days of mourning for my father are at hand, then will I slay my brother Jacob. See? That's what you fail to realize, LeBron, and all you, unbelievers out there, that Esau hates you, man. Yeah, he hates you. And these words of Esau, her elder son, were told to Rebekah. and she sent him Kyle. She sent and called her Shalakia, and she sent and called her and called Jacob her younger son, and said unto him, "Behold, thy brother Esau, as touching thee, do comfort himself, proposing to kill thee." That's his intention, man, to kill thee. Okay. So that's what LeBron and all these people failed to realize, man. Obadiah chapter 1. And let me get a. Let me start at verse 8. It says, Obadiah 1 and verse 8. "Shall I not in that day, saith the Lord, even destroy the wise man out of Edom, and understanding out of the mount of Esau? And thy mighty men, O Teman, shall be dismayed to the end, that every one of the mount of Esau may be cut off by slaughter. For thy violence against thy brother Jacob, shame shall cover thee, and thou shalt be cut out forever." Okay. Yeah, man. You did a whole lot to your brother. Okay. So, Abba Radazai, y'all was edified. That's what that is, man. Let me play this again, because in that day that's coming, Jacob trouble, you finna see race wars, class wars. You're gonna see, man, who your enemy is. Y'all gonna see, man. Okay, you got the men on the highways and byways and doing these sit-down lessons, trying to edify y'all and warn y'all, man, through the spirit and power of y'all by Shemal Shah, who the world ignorantly and incorrectly called God and Jesus Christ. Okay. These false leaders ain't going to tell y'all what's going on, okay? See, when you come upon a great millstone, you listen to great millstone, you get the 100% truth. You get understanding, okay? We're just trying to tell y'all, and I'm not a member of great millstone, but I fellowship with them brothers, man, okay? Made beautiful points according to the Bible, man. They bring them scriptures out and break them down, and guess what? I'm just teaching what I've been taught. So, Abba Radazai, Lord willing, y'all was edified. Until the next time, I would like to close out this lesson by giving all glory, honor, and infinite praises to Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, Bahashem, Racha Kodash, double honors to the apostles and elders of Great Millstone that teach and rule well and labor in 100% doctrine, okay, who I learned this truth from according to the Bible. Shalom to the hopeful elect, pushing this truth in our righteousness and the sincerity around the four winds of the earth. Shalom to the sincere believers and the few Akwaf being silent, coming back, listening, okay. Baba Baal, Kwame Asha Allah, Shalom.
I was a Lakers fan too before he said that.
Really?
Yeah.
I was really pissed off when he said that because I like LeBron, and then I'm like, you know what? F*** you, LeBron.
Seriously.